Hello, welcome to OnQA. In this session, we are going to talk about how we could create domains and projects into the ALM. In the previous sessions, we have discussed about the complete administration module, the in and out. Now let's concentrate on the domain creation and the projects creation. So let's go and talk about in detail with respect to admin module, adding a domain and creating projects to that. So let's get started. So let me open up the tool and let's open up the browser and let's go to the main page. So this is the application lifecycle management, the main segmentation page, and let's navigate to the site administration. And we need to log in into the system. And let's log in into the ALM by using the admin and the admin password. So let's click on login now. And now we have logged in into the system. Once logged in, you could see the domain, project, users. Now let's concentrate first of all, how do we create domains and projects? And then we would talk about how we could proceed to create the users and assign them to the different projects. To do that, so let me give you the brief about what is a domain, what is a project. So what is a domain? And domain is a common keyword. And we could see that in all the places. The domain expertise. Are you into this domain? So what is this domain? When I say domain, domain is a category, a business streamline or a segmentation. Example, automobile is one domain. Financial is one domain, e-cart or the e-commerce is one domain. So what is the domain here? When I say domain, it's a category. Example, if we take e-commerce, in the e-commerce we have lot of e-shop or shopping cart applications or e-cart application or online shopping based applications like Amazon, like Flipkart, like Snapdeal. So these are all in the point of online marketing, online shopping, and they do part of a domain called e-commerce. If I say banking applications, ICICI Bank, insurance related, HDFC or Bank of America. So all these streamlines would be in the banking domain. If I say automobile, the Toyota cars, the Innova cars or the Tata cars or the Suzuki. So all these streamlines fall into that automobile category. So domain is a segmentation. Domain is a group. Domain is a branch. Domain is a variation, a category where several things belong to that. Now, in this perspective, how do we say it's a domain? Example, in an organization, we have several domains. Software industry, and then sales industry, and then IT division, HR division, marketing division. So all these divisions can be a domain. When it comes to the applications, when it comes to the software, we can create domains kind of IT. We can create domains kind sales. We can create domains kind of software or human resource. So let's go and start with that now. So I would create on the button called create domain. And what is the domain? I would say, let me proceed with IT. And in the IT, we have a lot of projects. And let me just go and create a project. I would say my project name is, example, project one, which belongs to IT domain. And you could select the different divisions or different domains. Since we have created only one IT domain, either IT or default domain. Let me pick IT. Let me say next. And I would still use my server name where my ALM is installed. On that server, we're using the MySQL or MS SQL. We are going to create this project. Let me say OK. And you could see this is going to be enabled. And then we are good. And then it would ask us to add the project users. So let's not do that. We would anyway add users in the next session, but let's go and complete this adding a domain and adding projects to that. So it says what are all the different permissions that we require to do that. Let me select everything and let's go with the next. And let's click on yes and create. And you could see a domain is created. A domain name is called IT. Under the domain, the first project that we have created is project one. But project one is not a standard name. Now what I wanted to create a new domain, which is a meaningful domain like e-commerce or sales or automobile or online shopping cart. And then I would create different projects. We would simulate a company organization domain. Now you could see that the project created successfully. So let me click on yes. And now you could notice a project is created. So it leads us to the lab management, which we don't need at this point of time. So let me close this. And you could notice IT domain is created and under the project, we have project one. So this is not a meaningful name. So let's go and create one another with a proper meaning. Let's go to the default. And I wanted to create a domain. This time my domain is e-commerce. Let me say, okay. And you could see e-commerce domain is created. Under the project, I wanted to create a new project. And the project name, what we wanted is example, Amazon. And what is the domain? Is it in the IT or is it in the e-commerce? Let's assume that this project belongs to e-commerce segmentation in our company. So let's choose the e-commerce domain and continue to click on next. And this is the database server name. And if you wanted to pick other, you can add them one by one. Since we have created only one database and only one is part of this, let's click on next. And that should be okay. And let me not add all the users except one administrator and click continue to next. And if you want, you can create the multiple options. Let me choose all the options provided. And let me click on next. And it says the following extension do not have valid license. That should be okay. Let me click on yes. And we are done. And let's finish by clicking the button called create. Now you would notice under the e-commerce domain, you could see e-commerce domain. So under this domain, there is a project could be created called the Amazon. And now we can add multiple projects into that e-commerce, like Flipkart or the Snapdeal or whatsoever the e-commerce application that we wanted to place, that can be created under e-commerce domain. Similar to that, we could create multiple domains, HR domain, and payroll is one segment, and resources management is another segment. So under HR domain, we have payroll project, we have resources management project, we have any other management process under HR. So like that, we can create domains. It's not just one, we could create multiple domains, and under the domain, we could be able to create multiple the projects. Now, once it is done, we could still create another project. Let me just go and say, create a project. This time, our project name is example, e-cart. Our project name is e-cart. Let me just go and mention that. And this particular e-cart application is under, is it under IT domain or is it under e-commerce domain? Let's assume this e-cart application is also under e-commerce. Let's choose e-commerce domain. Let's continue. Let's continue. And let's continue adding one only administrator now. Next. And this time I don't want these add-ins. Let me say next. And then let me say create. Now you could notice under the e-commerce domain, we have two projects. One, the Amazon project. The other one, the e-cart project. And Amazon project would have 100 users and e-cart project would have 1,000 users. And then we can go and add the users and avail them to that particular corresponding project. So this is the way we could create multiple domains, multiple projects into the ALM. And this is the way we can make use of the application called ALM, Application Lifecycle Management, and we could make use of the module called Administration. So in the administration, it allows us to create multiple projects. So when I enlarge it, you could see there are multiple tables, users, actions, alert, components, reports, and we don't need to talk about each and everything because this is not our job. The only job that we might need to know, what is the administration module? And in the administration module, how do we create a domain? And as we create a domain, what is a domain? And once we know what is a domain, how do we create the domains? And into the domains, how do we create the project? Like e-commerce domain, IT domain, HR domain, or PeopleSoft domain. So we could create multiple domains, and then we could add multiple projects. Once projects are created, then we can go and proceed to add or create multiple users and assign them the access to that particular project in that particular domain. So this is what required. And now we know how to create domains, how to create projects. In case we don't require this domain anymore, so how do we delete this? So let's go and let's say this project is not required. So we can simply delete that project first. Once the project is deleted, let me say my username password is administrator and my password is, let me just go and get the password, place it here and submit that. And you could see that with that credentials, this particular project could be deleted. Once this project is deleted, then it would allow us to remove or delete the particular domain as well. So this is the way we can be easily able to create multiple projects and easily able to delete when it is not required. Example, now I wanted to remove this domain. So select the domain, just go and say delete the domain. Are you sure you want to delete this IT domain? Of course, yes. Let me say yes. And you can see that domain is removed. So this is the way it allows us to create domains, it allows us to create project, it allows us to delete the domains, and it allows us to delete the project as well. Since we understand this domain and projects addition, updation, deletion, in the next session we would talk about how do we create users and how do we provide access to the project. So that is the intention, and that we would continue to talk about that in the next session. So thank you so much. Thanks for watching the video. Hope you liked it. So let me summarize what we have discussed in this session. So in this session, we have concentrated and understood all about in the administration module, in the ALM administration or in the admin module, how we could create domains, how we could create multiple projects. And once the domains and projects created, we could be able to update them. We could be able to delete them. So the domains and projects concept is clear now. Now we can proceed and talk about continuation to that, how we can create users, add them to different project, and give access to based on specific role, based on specific project. So that we would talk about in the next session. So thank you so much. Thanks for watching the video. Hope you liked it. So please visit earnqio.com. There are so many videos, presentations, articles, books, and PDFs with respect to automation, test management, performance testing, and functional testing. So thank you so much and see you again. Mm-hmm.